Roughly about a year now, I did a video about 5 essential tools for beginner UX designers. But if you have seen that video already, then stick around for this one and we will talk about the 5 essential tools for advanced product designers. If you're new here, hi, what's up? I'm Gemma and I'm a senior product designer who share tips about UX for free. If that's something you're interested in, then why not hit that subscribe button? Turn on the notification bell to get notified every time I upload a new video. Before we start, I just want to let you know that none of the products within this video sponsored me. This is just products that I personally love and think that you would benefit if you are also an advanced product designer. First up, we have Figma Mirror. In my previous video, I talked about Figma as being the choice of tool to use if you're just starting out in UX. Figma also has an app called Figma Mirror where you are able to log into your Figma account and view your designs on your mobile device. This is a great tool to test any of your mobile designs and to test out to make sure that your touch targets are appropriate for that device. All you really need to do is to log into Figma on your mobile device and select the artboard that you would like to view, and you are able to get instant feedback right away. The next tool is Useberry. Product design will contain a lot of usability testing, so it's an essential to have a software that you can remotely usability test with participants. With a product such as Useberry, you are able to remotely test your ideas just by sending out participants a unique link. You can use this link for a group of particular participants, or you could test it with on social media, so to post it on LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, you name it. You are able to find participants and test your solutions. Useberry has a range of tests that you can choose from, and you're able to sign up for free and start testing for free. Next up, GoodNotes. GoodNotes is an app for your iPad, and I love using this app to scribble down ideas and take down meeting notes. I use GoodNotes because it allows me to keep everything digital, and it also allows me to keep everything within one place. Doing this allows me to share scribbles with my team, maybe share meeting notes with my team, and it also allows me to keep all my notes in a secure location, much better than putting everything down on a piece of paper. Next up, analytics software. There's various analytics software that I use personally, and these range from free versions such as Google Analytics all the way up to Hotjar and sometimes Beusable. I use analytics software such as these to gain insights into the products or websites that I'm working on, and it allows me to make improvements based on user behavior. I'm personally running analytics software on my website, and this allows me to update my website whenever I feel that it's appropriate by using user insights and data to drive my click conversion. And the last one would be project management tools. I've used a range of project management tools throughout my career, and the most common ones I've used is Jira and Monday.com. Using such tools help me prioritize my workload and manage my delivery of the projects. I am able to keep all my tasks in one place and able to track my tasks throughout the whole project. Both of these tools are paid for, but you can get free alternative tools which pretty much do the same job, such as Notion and Trello. If you're just looking for a simple Kanban board, then I do recommend going for Trello first just to test it out and whether or not it works for you. But if you're looking for a more in-depth kind of project, then I do suggest to use Notion as it has a bunch of templates predefined that you're able to access for free. And that's it. That's my list of tools for advanced product designers. I've linked everything that we spoke about in this video in the description below, and if you have any questions, then please let me know within the comment section. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you have, then please let me know within the comments below. If you haven't already subscribed, please subscribe or give it a like or comment. Anything you do on this video really helps my engagement. I am really trying to grow this channel, so if anything you can do can help, then please do. If you didn't know, I do have a Super Peer page as well where I offer one-on-one mentoring sessions, and you can find the link in the description below. And also, if you want to follow me over on Instagram, you can do so here. And until next time, bye!